So what I'm about to do is show you a video that's basically a compilation detailing the media coverage of Bernie Sanders back when he was still a presidential candidate versus the kind of coverage he received after he wore mittens to Joe Biden's inauguration. Take a look.
Breaking news. 2020 presidential candidate Bernie Sanders has released his tax returns. I got very excited. I started getting ahead of myself. Bernie Sanders is a millionaire.
Bernie Sanders makes my skin crawl, and I can't even identify for you what exactly it is.
The confrontation over whether Senator Bernie Sanders once told Senator Elizabeth Warren that a woman cannot be elected president.
And Sanders was pressed on his recent comments to 60 Minutes about Fidel Castro.
Could his voting history be a liability for Senator Sanders?
It was about you as an existential threat.
Because now that Bernie has it, he's coming for your money.
The Soviet Union. They had wonderful chandeliers.
I want receipts. What has he actually done in all of this time to actually deliver?
I'm reading last night about the fall of France in the summer of 1940, and the general, Renault, calls up Churchill and says, it's over. So I had that suppressed feeling. I can't be as wild as Carville, but he is damn smart, and I think he's damn right on this.
The Democratic nomination will not be successful. And so today, I am announcing the suspension of my campaign. Please know that I do not make this decision lightly.
The fact that you have become a meme of the picture of you sitting at the inauguration in your mittens, thousands of memes, such as some of them on the screen. I have to show you some of my personal favorites.
Senator, thanks so much for joining us. And I know this is an issue that is close to your heart.
Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time, Senator.
But that just made the internet love him even more, right?
I mean, loved is kind of an understatement at this point.
All right, Senator Sanders, maybe I'll call you Mr. Secretary one of these days. Thanks so much for joining.
Let's talk about it. Bernie Sanders absolutely breaking the internet with his drip, his inauguration chic.
Joy Reid today. I will admit to being a past Medicare for All skeptic. I can't think of one good reason today to keep the current system.
Bernie Sanders, George, wore a pair of mittens made out of an old sweater.
He is nothing if not on brand.
Okay, so I don't know about you guys, but the first thing that I noticed, and this isn't anything new, they've always had a bias against Bernie Sanders or any progressive person that's a politician in this country. Back when he was still a presidential candidate and it looked like he could win and he was leading in every poll, a lot of states, it was all systems go. Like, release the hounds, attack, smear, propaganda, endless smears against this man. Things that didn't even make sense. I remember that one thing where CNN did a whole segment about him, like hitting a punching bag, and they brought up his age, and it, like, almost came back to hit him in the face, and they just made it a big, it was, like, so ridiculous. Like, it sounds ridiculous for me to explain it, doesn't it? So when he was a presidential candidate and it looks like he had a path to victory, all systems go, we got to get him out of here. So, of course, as you know, he did not win the presidential nomination. He lost to Joe Biden. And after that, things didn't really settle down much. They were still kind of attacking him. Even after Joe Biden won, he still received a little bit of flack. But after the inauguration, as you saw, everything was hunky-dory. You know, they had quelched the movement. They had defeated Bernie Sanders, and now it's groveling at his feet because he wore mittens. These people have no shame. They're vapid shells instead of human beings. They don't believe in anything. They just work for these big corporate media companies and push endless propaganda to preserve the status quo. You know, that one woman in the beginning saying, Bernie Sanders makes my skin crawl, and can't even give a reason as to why. Comparing him to the likes of Fidel Castro and Hugo Chavez and Maduro of Venezuela, none of that makes any sense whatsoever. But it's a straw man. They're trying to straw man him into, you know, people leaving from him and giving their support to someone else, a serious candidate. You know what I mean? The likes of Kamala Harris and Joe Biden, for example, the people that are currently in the White House. You know, it's so striking. They don't even hide. their bias. And they'll be the people to tell you, well, you know, CNN will tell you, you know, they have no bias. They just give you the facts. They're straight shooters. They'll tell you how it is. No, but they do. They do propaganda for the Democrats, but more so propaganda for the establishment. That's what it is. That's what it is. You know, Bernie Sanders, his campaign, it was against him, and it was rigged against him in 2016, and it was also rigged against him in 2020. Maybe not in the same way, but the Democratic establishment coalesced and crushed his campaign. And one thing that they like to do on corporate media is compare him to Donald Trump. They love to say that Bernie Sanders is like the left-wing Donald Trump, which isn't true in any sense. But let's pretend that it is. So one thing about Donald Trump that corporate media loves to do, and people in general loves to do, is, you know, call him a fascist and say that his movement is based on fascism and whatnot. Now, I wouldn't go as far as to say that because it's really not true. But do certain aspects of it kind of resemble certain aspects of fascism? I'll give that to you. But the quote unquote fascist was able to make it into the White House, and he held on to power for 4 years. Now, of course, he was recently expelled from that position. But the socialist can't break the door down. He can't get in. They won't let the socialist in. The Democratic Socialist or the Social Democrat, whatever you want to label him as, they won't let him in. Why is that? Why won't they let him in? He was denied in 2016. He was denied once again in 2020. See, there's a difference. The far right, as it pertains to capitalism, which is the kind of system that we have in this country, they don't want to get rid of it. They want to kind of work alongside it. The people on the left, the more progressive members, they do want to change the system. They do want to implement, maybe in some cases, a new system, if not, you know, want to make certain changes to certain aspects of the system and still have certain aspects remain. You know what I mean? See, that threatens the power and the overall bottom line of the people that have bought and own our government currently. Which is why they'll never be allowed to break the door down and grab power. Like, they will always be more hostile to the left than they will ever be to the far right. And, you know, they love to paint him as a radical and extremist. I'm referring to Bernie Sanders. But he's very much a centrist as it pertains to mainstream opinion in this country. You know, all of his policies fall right down the smack dab in the middle of what the American people want. The majority of American people want a nationalized health system. The majority of American people want to legalize marijuana. The majority of American people want to end the wars and raise wages and everything else. So, you know, and it kind of shows you that none of it's really working because the movement is still alive and well, even after he did not succeed in his most recent presidential campaign. And might I add that their ratings are falling. CNN, MSNBC, Fox, all of their ratings are falling because the spectacle that is Donald Trump no longer exists. They can't talk about Donald Trump all day, every day. If you watch a little bit of the news now, as of today, they're pushing this new Marjorie Taylor Greene thing. She's like their new boogeyman that they can be afraid of and talk about. That won't last long because Donald Trump is no more. He's no longer in the White House, so they can't talk about him all day, every day, as they once did. And so their ratings are tanking. And I'm very glad to see that because you shouldn't watch them anyway. You should watch me. No, seriously, watch me. But in regards to the inauguration event, even after he got all that, you know, that quote unquote exposure, I can't find the better word for it, from wearing mittens to an inauguration, some people still had something bad to say, like, oh, his demeanor. Seemed like he didn't want to be there. It seemed like he's upset because he lost. It seems to me like there's just this crowd of people that want Bernie Sanders subjugated. And they want to exert dominance over him and his movement in order to crush it. I find it funny how Joe Biden profusely lied on the campaign trail about a plethora of things, from his voting history to what he thought about healthcare, to how he was going to combat the pharmaceutical companies and health insurance companies, to what he, you know, he lied about not wanting to cut Social Security and Medicare. That's something that he wants to do or at least wanted to do with the grand bargain. And he still might do it. Who knows? You know, Bernie Sanders can't get away with things like that. He can't get away with lying about his past indifferences or past decisions. They won't allow that to happen, but they'll surely do cover-ups for all of the corporate Democrats. But this is nothing new. They've always hated Bernie Sanders. They will continue to hate him. The man that is fighting for healthcare, jobs, wages, ending the wars, is an endless recipient of constant hatred and vitriol from corporate and establishment media, and it's nothing new. Once again, here's another example of the media blowing with the wind.